Hello students, welcome back to a new lesson of op-amp application. In our previous videos, we have covered different types of op-amp applications. Since I have already told you that operational amplifier, it has a huge range of application, right? In analog electronics, you can have most of the devices that can be developed using op-amp. So here in this video, we will again cover some applications of op-amp. These are the topics that we are going to cover today. These are logarithmic amplifier, anti-logarithmic amplifier, and very important instrumentation amplifier. It's important in terms of your exam. It's important in terms of your project work. You can develop any kind of amplifier by using this instrumentation amplifier, okay? So these three are the one of the most applied application of op-amp. So let us first start with logarithmic amplifier. Now, what is logarithmic amplifier? In our last video, we have discussed about integrator differentiator using op-amp. As op-amp can be used for any mathematical or logical operation with similar point of view, this mathematical operation, logarithmic operation, can also be done using an operational amplifier. So a logarithmic amplifier, it can be easily said that whenever the output voltage is proportional to the logarithm of input voltage, that type of circuit, if we can design using op-amp, that is defined as logarithmic amplifier. So a logarithmic amplifier or a log amplifier is an electronic circuit that produces an output that is proportional to the logarithm of the applied input. An op-amp based logarithmic amplifier produces a voltage at the output. As you all know, in analog electronics, whenever we are talking about any voltage or current, that is the analog signal. So a logarithmic amplifier that produces a voltage at the output, which is proportional to the logarithm of the voltage applied to the resistor connected to its inverting terminal. Yes, again, there is a question of inverting and non-inverting. In most of the cases, we use inverting type amplifier. So what is inverting type amplifier? Whenever the input voltage is being provided to the inverting terminal, that is the negative terminal of an op-amp, that is known as inverting amplifier. These all types like inverting, non-inverting, integrator, differentiator, all are being discussed in the previous videos. I will share the links of those videos also, so you can go through those videos before you see this discussion of logarithmic amplifier. Now look at this circuit diagram. This is the logarithmic amplifier design. So we can have an op-amp. The input voltage is being applied, as I have already told you, in the inverting terminal. The positive terminal is being grounded, that non-inverting, and the feedback path. In case of integrator differentiator, we have seen that the feedback path was designed using capacitor, right? So in this case, that feedback path is being designed with the use of diode. This is the difference between a normal operation of op-amp and a logarithmic amplifier. So the non-inverting terminal, as you can see here, it's being connected to ground. That means zero voltage is applied at the non-inverting input terminal. Now, if we consider the virtual short concept, the point where the incoming current and the feedback current is getting connected, at that point, if we apply the nodal equation, we can have that Vi minus Vi by R1 plus feedback current equal to zero. Now in our basic electronics, we have already studied about diode and the current of forward equation of diode. So the forward bias equation of current for a diode can be written as its incoming current into e to the power terminal voltage divided by N into VA. Now, what is IS? IS is the saturation current of diode. For a particular diode, there will be a rated saturation current that is denoted by IS. So, IS we can get from the rated value of diode. VF is the voltage drop across diode when it is forward biased. VT is the thermal equivalent voltage. Now, if we apply KVL equation in the feedback loop of the op amp, it will become minus VF minus V0 equal to 0. Since this is being an inverting amplifier, so the minus VF is being used. Now, substitute the value of VF in equation 2 and we can have the equation 3, that is the value of forward bias current of IF. Again, observe the left-hand side terms of both equation 1 and 3. Hence, we can equate the right-hand side and we can write VI by R1 equals to IS into e to the power minus V0 by N into VT. And see, from this equation, if we replace the value of E, we need to take log in both sides. And from there, we can write that natural logarithm, that is ln of VI by R1 into IS equals to minus V0 by N into VT. So in the above equation, if the parameters N, VT and IS are constant, and we can conclude that the output voltage V0 will be proportional to the natural logarithm of the input voltage VI for a fixed value of resistance R1. Therefore, the op-amp based logarithmic amplifier circuit discussed will be produce an output which is proportional to the natural logarithm of the input voltage VT when R1 IS equals to 1 volt. Here we have observed negative sign, which indicates that there exists a 180 degree phase difference between the input and the output. And you can assume that why this negative sign is being there, because this is a construction of an inverting op amp, and whenever we are design an inverting op amp, there will be a phase shift between the input voltage and the output voltage. So this was all about a logarithmic amplifier. Next we will cover anti-log amplifier. An anti-log amplifier or an anti-logarithmic amplifier is an electronic circuit that produces an output that is proportional to the anti-logarithm of the applied input. Now, from the concept of integrator and differentiator, you can easily assume that the place of diode and the resistor will be interchanged, and the same thing has been done over here. In our previous diagram, in the diagram of logarithmic amplifier, diode has been used as the feedback element, whereas here diode is being used as the input element, and as a feedback resistance, here we have used a resistor. With a similar concept, here also the non-inverting terminal is being grounded, that is the voltage applied over the positive terminal is zero, and by using virtual concept of an op amp and by using nodal equation at the input terminal, we can write minus IF plus minus V0 by RF equal to zero, and from there we can have a equation of voltage V0, that is minus RF into IF. This is our feedback part. Now come to the input part. Here we must know the equation of forward bias current of diode. So again, IF equals to IS into e to the power VF by NVT. And if we substitute the value of IF in the equation of output voltage, we can write V0 equal to minus RF into the substituted value of IF. And from there, we can have our equation output voltage, which is proportional to the anti-log of input voltage. So if again the parameters N, VT and IS are considered to be constant, the output voltage will be proportional to anti-logarithm of the input voltage Vi for a fixed value resistance of Rf. So an anti-logarithmic amplifier and a logarithmic amplifier both are being used to perform the mathematical operation of log and anti-log, and this can be easily designed by using an op-amp. The external parameters, the external element that we need to design an anti-log or logarithmic amplifier is a diode. Next, instrumentation amplifier. As I've already told, it's also important from your exam point of view, because each and every year from op-amp application, they maintain a question about instrumentation amplifier. It may be in terms of a short note about the application of instrumentation amplifier or the principal operation of instrumentation amplifier. So before we answer this question, we need to know what is an instrumentation amplifier. An instrumentation amplifier is used to amplify very low level signals, rejecting noise and interference signals. See, some of the cases, it's not mandatory that we are getting 230 volt or we are getting 440 volt or any three phase. Since we are dealing with electronic devices, we have to deal with very low signals. And that low signals may be in terms of millivolt or microvolt range. But this is not mandatory that all our devices can record the low level signals. And in those cases, the application of instrumentation amplifier comes. So an instrumentation amplifier, as the name implies, it can amplify the need of voltage level or the need of signal levels according to the instrument that are being used in the project. So it's used to amplify very low level signal. So what are the characteristics of an instrumentation amplifier? Inputs to the instrumentation amplifier will have very low signal energy. Therefore, the instrumentation amplifiers should have high gain and should be accurate. The gain should be easily adjustable using a single control. It should be easily controlled. Otherwise, we cannot incorporate it into a project where many other instruments are being used. It must have high input impedance and low output impedance to prevent loading. Since it's an amplifier, since it's being designed using op-amp, so the main property of op-amp is also present over here. That is, it has high input impedance and low output impedance. The instrumentation amplifier should have high CMRR, since the transducer output will usually contain common mode signals such as noise when transmitted over long wires. It must also have a high slew rate to handle sharp rise times of events and provide a maximum undistorted output voltage swing. So these are the essential characteristics of instrumentation amplifier. Now, what are the advantages? The gain of a 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. Why it's being called as 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier? When I come to the next slide, I can show you the circuit design of an instrumentation amplifier, and there you can see that it's being designed using 3 op-amps. So it's also known as 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. So it can be easily varied by adjusting the value of only one resistor. The gain of the amplifier depends only on the external resistor used. The input impedance is very high due to the emitter follower configuration of amplifier 1 and 2. The output impedance of the instrumentation amplifier is very low due to the difference amplifier 3. The CMRR of the op-amp 3 is very high and almost all of the common mode signal will be rejected. Now, what is the difference? Is there any difference between a normal op-amp and an instrumentation amplifier? Yes, there is some differences that we can find between these two types of amplifier. So an operational amplifier is one kind of an integrated circuit. We all know that we can have operational amplifier op amp using just 741 IC, right? But we have to design an instrumentation amplifier. It cannot be obtained from market using any IC. So the instrumentation amplifier is one type of differential amplifier. Instrumentation amplifier can be built with three operational amplifiers. The differential amplifier can be built with a single operational amplifier. The output voltage of different amplifier gets affected because of the mismatched resistors. Instrumentation amplifier offers gain with a single resistor of its primary phase, which does not need a resistor matching. So these are the difference between a normal op amp and an instrumentation amplifier. Yes, here is the diagram of instrumentation amplifier using op amp. As I have already told you that it's a three op amp instrumentation amplifier. Yes, you can see here that total three number of op amps have been used over here. First, two voltages V1 and V2 are being applied in op amp 1 and 2, and a differential amplifier op amp 3 is being used as a differential amplifier, where the voltages from op amp 1 and 2 are used as the input. So op amp 1 and 2 are non-inverting amplifier and op amp 3 is a differential amplifier. These three op amps together form an instrumentation amplifier. Instrumentation amplifier's final output, Vout, is the amplified difference of the input signals applied to the input terminals of op amp 3. If the output voltage from op amp 1 and op amp 2 are V1 and V2, then we can write output voltage of the instrumentation amplifier, that is Vout equals to R3 by R2 into V1 minus V2. This is the working details of instrumentation amplifier, using which we can design an instrumentation amplifier. So we have just take the part. We have just taken the part of op amp 1 again and the part of op amp 2. And then by adding those two outputs and applying that to a differential amplifier, we have designed the ultimate output of instrumentation amplifier. So here you can see that the difference of two op amp, that is V01 minus V02, has been calculated, and ultimately the output, V output, has been obtained, which is proportional to the difference between V01 and V02. Now, what are the application of instrumentation amplifier? Where do we use this type of amplifiers? Instrumentation amplifiers are used in data acquisition for small output transducer like thermocouples, strain gauge, measurement of Wheatstone bridge, etc. These amplifiers are used in navigation, medical, radar, etc. These amplifiers are used to enhance the signal to noise ratio in audio application, like audio signal with low amplitude. These amplifiers are used for imaging as well as video data acquisition in the conditioning of high-speed signal, and these are used in RF cable system for amplification of the high-frequency signal. So these are the important application of instrumentation amplifier. So in this video, we have covered about logarithmic amplifier, anti-logarithmic amplifier, and instrumentation amplifier. About logarithmic amplifier and anti-logarithmic amplifier, you have studied that these are the mathematical operations that we can perform using op amp. When the output voltage is proportional to the natural logarithm of input voltage, that is defined by logarithmic amplifier, and the vice versa can be defined by anti-logarithmic amplifier. In aspect of design point of view, there is a new element that's being used, that is a diode in place of input resistor or in place of feedback resistor in case of log amplifier or anti-log amplifier. Now for instrumentation amplifier, it's a 3 op amp amplifier which is used to amplify any low level signal. But the two inputs op amp that are being used, these are used as a non-inverting amplifier, and the number 3 amplifier that is used is by differential amplifier. So these are all we have covered in this video. If you have any doubts regarding any parts from this video, you can share that in the comment section and I will definitely solve it. So thank you once again for watching this video. Thank you.